Hey everyone, thank you for joining me. So today I have a BergBlades Iron Pup. Now this blade was provided by a supporter of the channel, so I just wanted to give a shout out to Ross. And also, thank you Ross for not only purchasing this blade, but also getting it sent straight to me and allowing me to do the unboxing. So again, thank you very much for that. Now I've always wanted to handle a BergBlades Iron Pup. I've seen it thousands of times on Instagram. So today is the day I get to experience it, and not only that, but unbox it as well. So I wanted to take a peek earlier, but I held back, and we're just going to be surprised. So let's just get straight to it. Now, really quick, I just wanted to show the box. It's actually really nice. I know it's just a box, but it's just really, really quality. And it's really cool that the labeling is kind of a gold imprint, so it's actually got texture on it. So just really, already just really clean and really nice packaging. So let's open it up and see what we got here. So we have a business card, so there is that, really nice. And then, oh wow, it's even signed here. Certificate of Authenticity. So you got the model production iron pup, steel CPM 20CV. That's awesome because I wasn't sure exactly what steel it had. Handle material titanium, and then the hardware is actually all titanium, and there it is. But there you go, that's really cool, and that is really awesome. Look at that, you guys, you get a sticker. So good on you, BergBlades. That's what I'm talking about. So awesome that you get a sticker. I know it's a little thing, but it's just, I'm really big on stickers. So when it is provided in a knife or a package, that's just, it's really cool. It's a really cool sticker too. Buff guy with tats. So there it is. Awesome that it comes with a sticker. That actually makes me really happy. Even though I'm not gonna keep the sticker, it's gonna go back to Ross, but still. If you do buy a blade like this, it's gonna have a sticker. And not only do you have a very firm foam cutout, but the knife is actually in plastic as well. So very, very well packaged so far. Sealed really well. So I highly doubt there's gonna be any scratches on this thing. But let's get it out of the plastic bag. And definitely has some weight to it. I'll get my scale in just a moment. But let's just take a... So you got oil on here, which is fine. That's not a problem. It's a etched and stonewashed titanium. Before I flip it out, let's give you guys a good look at it too. It's a very clean design. One of the reasons why I wanted to purchase one, it's just way out of my price range. But one of the reasons I really was drawn towards this blade is just so clean and simply designed. Just really, really like it. And that stone wash is just gorgeous on the titanium. Really, really nice. You got that jimping. Even the stress cutouts on the lock bar are really nice. Just looks really, really good. Nice pocket clip. Flows really well with the design of the knife too. I like when a pocket clip goes with the knife as well. Some knives are just, it's just a randomly shaped pocket clip. But there it is. Let's give this thing a, we'll do a thumb flick first, see what happens. Very nice, really smooth. Flew out and it locked up nicely. There's the BergBlades logo, really nice and simple. And on the other side is nothing, just really, really clean. Gorgeous blade. It's a clip point style blade with a, I believe, a DLC coating with a stonewash to match the stonewash scale. So it just flows really, really well. And it is a hollow grind, and you got a nice swedge up here on top. So just a really clean, very thin edge. So more than likely, I'm sure it's gonna slice. Just really quick, let's do a paper cut test just to see if this knife does come sharp. So here we go, let's just give it a quick test. Like butter, just right through that paper, no problem. Comes very sharp. Yeah, that is a clean and smooth blade. Just gorgeous. I just really, really like it. Again, not mine, so I'm gonna be very careful with this knife. I don't know exactly the price of this blade, but I'll put it up on screen because I don't know exactly how much these things go for, but I know they're over the $200 range. Yeah, I just really, really like how everything matches, and it just basically all blacked out. Just a gorgeous, gorgeous blade. I know I keep saying that, but really, really nice. And it's got a good weight to it. Let's see if, see how the drop shit is. Okay. Brand new, so it's not gonna drop shut, but you just wiggle it a little bit and it does drop shut. I believe it's writing on bearings. Yes, it is writing on bearings. Let's see if we can spidey flick this thing. Oh yeah, no problem. Easily spidey flickable, if that's even a term. But yeah, that's really, really nice. Perfectly centered. I mean, it doesn't get any more center than that. Nice backspacer too. A little bit of shaping to it. It's not just a flat, boring backspacer. So I really do like that. Very nice. And not a deep carry pocket clip, but not a problem for me. Honestly, as long as a knife has a pocket clip, I'm happy. So again, just really nice, flows with the shape of the blade or the knife itself. And from how I opened it, you guys know that it does have two thumb studs. Really nice jimping. So the jimping is, it grips the thumb. It's not aggressive, but it does bite into the thumb very well. And then you do have actually a little bit of a forward finger choil there. So you can choke up on this blade if need be. So again, just really, really good ergos too. Fits comfortably in hand. And again, that weight is really nice. I'm gonna get my scale out and we can give it a really quick weigh. So let's see what we got here. I'm gonna be careful not to scratch this thing. We're looking at 3.74 ounces. So not crazy heavy and not crazy light either. But I think it is an all-around really good knife. First impressions, obviously, but so far really, really smooth. And again, just love the look of the blade. Let me know what you guys think down below. I always appreciate your guys' comments and your guys' thoughts. So feel free to let me know what you guys think of the Iron Pup. Now, another blade by BergBlades that I really would really love to own one day is the Slim. I'll put a picture of that blade up somewhere up on the screen, but it's a knife that I really, really like. It's stubby, kind of my go-to knife. One of the reasons why I got the KTC2 that you guys saw in an unboxing video where I opened up the box. But a full review is coming on that blade for sure, because I just love that blade. But the Slim is another great blade by BergBlades. Just really awesome look to it. But there is the Iron Pup. Really nice and clean. Oh, and also before I forget, Ross sent this blade in because he's going to want a fat carbon scale, show side scale, done for this blade. So it'll be interchangeable. I'm not really going to mess with anything else on this blade other than just copying the scale out of a different material. That way he has some options. So that is what I will be doing here in the near future for this blade. So again, thank you to Ross. And I will put the website of where Ross got this blade. He told me it was Grayman Industries. I wrote it down. So I will put Grayman Industries website down below, and you guys can go check out their knives. They have quite a bit of a selection of knives, ones that are kind of hard to get. So again, check them out, and appreciate you guys watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share these videos. And as always, I will see you on the next one.